She's in the semi-final. The first Brazilian to make it to a Grand Slam semi-final for 45 years. Lovely from Ons. She must feel wretched the way this turned against her. But well played, Bea Haddad Maia. What a day for her and for Brazil.
Well, blown away by her attitude. I just thought, even, you know, set down 5-all, 15-40 down, I thought Jabeur had it. But she fought and fought, as she has done in the last, this, what, fourth match in a row, she's done it. Fantastic. She believed. And in the end, Jabeur had no belief left at all. Incredible turnaround.
Et je demandais d'accompagner Ons Jabeur, qui était en quart de finale.
I say goodbye to Ons, who's given us so much, but this not her year. It's the Brazilians' day. Yes, four times she's been in three-set matches. Three times in a row she's come from a set down.
That's just really incredible. I mean, that last game from Jabeur, the errors she made.
Yeah, she'd gone, hadn't she?
Gone completely, yeah. I don't think she could quite believe it. It just had gone in, you know, so quickly. Well played, though, Haddad
Maia.
Bea, congratulations. Amazing effort. The first thing you did when you won the last point is put your hands into your face. You can't believe it. You just won. So we can just say, good job. You just reached the semifinals here. The first female Brazilian in the Open era. To play Ons is such a difficult opponent because she's a great tactician, but you hang in there, especially in the second set where you just reached the tiebreak, and we were thinking, I don't know how you're going to handle, because you came from an almost 4 hours match the last round. So how did you recover physically and emotionally from that?
Well, first of all, I would like to thank everybody who came today to support me. Especially the Brazilians. Yeah, I think in Grand Slams we have the chance to recover for one day. So even when I played more than 3 hours, I had a day off, and I have an amazing team. My physio is here, so we could work very hard also in the body. My coach also in my mind. So yeah, I think this is tennis. We work all year long to be in this moment. So yeah, I remember that in the middle of the second set, my coach showed me the clock, and I looked, it was 1 hour and something. I said, okay, maybe we have until I have ahead. So yeah, I had to be patient. I had to keep doing the shots, because as you said, she's a pretty good player. She's one of the best players in the world, even in the clay court. So I'm very happy and proud of me and my team today.
And women's tour, everybody hits so hard. So tactically, is it completely different? Is it more difficult to play against someone that she does a lot of drop shots? She forced you to come into the net many times. Also, you being lefty, you know, you can open up the court very well. So how did you use a little bit your mindset to prepare against someone that is very difficult? And by the way, great sportsmanship from Ons at the end of the match, giving you a hug.
Yeah, as I said yesterday, she's a very nice person, and this means a lot for us as a women tennis player. She represents us not only on the court, but also off court, so she's a really nice girl. and I know her, she's juniors as well. So yeah, not easy to play against her. She's tricky. Sometimes you do a good shot and you expect that you're going to have another shot to go, and then, okay, drop shot, winner. So yeah, you have to be patient. It's not easy to keep the rhythm with the shots also in 2-3 hours. So I always believe in my body. I always believe that the match is long. So I think that was the key. I was trying to keep my game and not think on her head. And yeah, I think it worked.
It worked very well. We don't want to keep you long here because you need to recover. They need to play some more matches. Parabéns. Muito contento por você.
Merci beaucoup.
Beatriz Haddad Maia, qualifiée pour la demi-finale de Roland-Garros.
The day of her life.
Hi, I'm John McEnroe, and welcome to Eurosport Tennis on YouTube. Click here to subscribe to Eurosport Tennis.